Major funding for the production of Granite State Challenge has been provided by Unitil, Energy for Life. NEA New Hampshire, shaping the future one student at a time, with additional funding from Heinemann Publishing, D.F. Richard, Markham Image, Pax World Funds, and from viewers like you. Thank you.
For 30 years, New Hampshire high school students have been matching wits in a high-stakes scholastic showdown. Get ready to take the Granite State Challenge. And here's your host, Jim Janot.
Hi again, everybody. Welcome to another game of Granite State Challenge. It is our fourth game of the season, meaning three teams have won to move into the quarterfinals. Two new teams tonight also hoping to advance to that round. But this all really began last November, a Super Sunday up at Plymouth State University, where 52 high school teams competed with a chance to make it to Granite State Challenge. Very busy day looking like this. It was a fun day and a busy day, and it resulted in 16 teams being selected for this competition. Two of them are here tonight, ready to compete, so let's do so. Let's introduce you to the team from Bishop Guertin High School. With an enrollment of some 866 students, Bishop Guertin High School is located in Hillsborough County.
Hi, I'm Tim, and I'm a sophomore.
Hi, I'm Jeff, and I'm a sophomore.
Hi, I'm Dave, and I'm a sophomore.
Hi, I'm Zach, and I'm a sophomore.
With us for the program, the coach for the team, Megan Davidson. The alternates are Isaiah Sirwa and David McCallie. They are the Cardinals of Bishop Guertin High School. All right, you've met Bishop Guertin. Let's introduce you to their opponents for tonight's game. This is the team from Merrimack High School. They have an enrollment of some 1,380 students. Merrimack High School, located in Hillsborough County.
Hi, I'm Allison, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Meslin, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm James, and I'm a junior.
Hi, I'm Dan, I'm a junior.
The team is coached by Sarah Campbell, and her alternates are Bailey Joseph and Jack Landry, the Tomahawk of Merrimack High School. One last introduction. We do this every week. We introduce you to our judges, and we say hello once again to Jim Johnston and Ann Belanger. Thank them for all their help. All right, round one is the same as it has been over all these years. 10-point toss-up question, so here we go, Bishop Guertin and Merrimack High School. The Edgar Award, given out every year by the Mystery Writers of America, is named after this author, Zachary of Bishop Guertin.
Edgar Allan Poe.
Edgar Allan Poe is correct. The song, I Will Always Love You, is often associated with Whitney Houston. But it was written and first performed at Timothy of Bishop Guertin.
Dolly Parton.
By this country music icon, Dolly Parton. You are correct for 10 points. What is the greatest common divisor of 12 and 8? Timothy of Bishop Guertin.
Four.
Four is correct. The Devon School and John Knowles' novel, A Separate Piece, Timothy of Bishop Guertin.
Phillips Exeter Academy.
Is based on this New Hampshire school. Phillips Exeter Academy is correct. The Neon Museum officially opened its doors in 2012. It is most appropriately located in this city. With all the bright lights, it's, sorry, I got to get that to you. Time was up. The answer is Las Vegas. On January 1st, 1994, this trade agreement between Canada, the United States, and Mexico went into effect. Dan of Merrimack.
North American Free Trade Agreement.
NAFTA is correct for your 10 points. Your team's on the board. The AM in radio stands for amplitude. Maslin of Merrimack.
Modulating.
I can repeat it for Bishop Guertin. The AM in radio stands for amplitude modulation. What does the FM in radio stand for? It stands for frequency modulation. This singer is sometimes called the queen of hip-hop soul. She is known for her albums, Timothy of Bishop Guertin.
Aretha Franklin.
To repeat it from Merrimack, this singer is sometimes called the queen of hip-hop soul. She is known for her albums, My Life and What's the 411. In October 2013, she released a Christmas album, A Merry Christmas. And it was Mary J. Blige. Here we go for 10 points. This is our first video question of the evening. Take a look right here and listen.
Hi, my name is John Gianforti. I'm an astronomy instructor for Granite State College and for the University of New Hampshire. The planets of our solar system have inspired more than just scientists. Can you name the English composer that created a seven-movement suite?
Timothy of Bishop Guertin.
Holtz.
Gustav Holtz is right for your 10 points. This actor has played Ace, Truman, Andy, Bruce, Horton, and the Grinch. Timothy of Bishop Guertin.
Jim Carrey.
Jim Carrey is correct. The polio vaccine was first tested in 1952. Who developed the polio vaccine, Timothy of Guertin?
Jonas Salk.
Jonas Salk is correct. In 1862, Abraham Lincoln signed this act into law, which allowed everyone, including freed slaves and women who were 21 years old or older and who hadn't taken up arms against the United States, to file for a federal land grant. The law was the Homestead Act. For 10 points, teams, this founding father's son, William, was the last royal governor of New Jersey. William was the son of Benjamin Franklin. All right, here's our 1984 question, which means we're celebrating 30 years, going back to 1984. Our 1984 question is thus worth, on our 30th anniversary, 30 points. The 1984 Summer Olympics were held in this U.S. city. Timothy of Bishop Guertin.
Los Angeles.
Los Angeles is right, so 30 points to celebrate our anniversary on the board to Bishop Guertin. The poet who is buried in Stark Cemetery in Dunbarton, New Hampshire, is considered to be one of the most important poets of the second half, Dan of Merrimack.
Robert Frost.
I can repeat it for Bishop Guertin. The poet who is buried in Stark Cemetery in Dunbarton, New Hampshire, is considered to be one of the most important poets of the second half of the 20th century. His 1959 Life Studies is considered by many to have changed modern poetry. His name is Robert Lowell. This Pulitzer Prize-winning author of histories and biographies is a diehard Red Sox fan and the author of Team of Rivals and The Bully Pulpit, Timothy of Bishop Guertin.
Doris Kearns Goodwin.
Doris Kearns Goodwin is right. This man was the first president who was part of the baby boom generation. And we were looking for, go ahead, Allison.
Jimmy Carter.
Now I got to give you a chance, Guertin. Timothy?
Lyndon B. Johnson.
Coming this way, close to Dwight time, it was Bill Clinton. For 10 points, this cartoonist is known for his macabre characters. Dan of Merrimack.
Rube Goldberg.
And repeat for Guertin. This cartoonist is known for his macabre characters like Gomez, Lurch, and Pugsley, who regularly appeared in The New Yorker and have gone on to be portrayed on TV sitcom and in the movies. The cartoonist was Charles Adams. For another 10 points, well, we'll wait on that because we've got a second round coming up. But Bishop Guertin getting the early jump here after round at number one over Merrimack. But the big bonus round is coming right up with a lot of points up for grabs. Before we get there, though, we're going to call on Lori Warriner as we do each and every week. She talks to the teams before the programs. Right now, she's talking with the team from Bishop Guertin.
Thank you, Jim. It's time for us to talk to the team from Bishop Guertin. Tim, you are the captain, and it's an all-underclassmen team. How did that happen?
Well, I guess it happened because I was actually the one who started the team.
Okay.
And so, you know, I kind of figured who better to get than my friends, who are mostly sophomores. So it's a very young team, but we're excited to be here.
Okay. Well, and when you're probably looking at it as like you can start a dynasty, right?
Exactly. We still have two more good years after this, so we're looking forward to it.
And then you can like find some good, smart, young freshmen and sophomores. All right, cool. Jeff, you are an accomplished violinist. Now, I don't know how you would manage to be as good as you are at such a young age.
Well, I started playing the violin when I was 6 years old, and I've been playing since then. I've made it, actually, to Allstate as a freshman, and I just got accepted this year as a sophomore.
That's an amazing accomplishment. Congratulations on that. And now, David, Top Gear. How did that become your favorite show?
I absolutely love it. I was watching the BBC one day, saw it happen to be on, and I was like, man, throw it on. Cars, fast cars and expensive cars. Love them.
Maybe someday, would that be like a dream of yours to be the next host?
I don't think I'd ever have that type of money to buy those cars, nor would anyone trust me with them.
I trust those guys with them either, though, but best of luck today. And David, Zachary, I'm sorry, Zach, fencing. How did you ever start doing that?
Well, it kind of started with my parents urging me to find some sort of outlet for physical activity. And I just thought to myself, what's something I could do that would let me stay inside still? And, of course, fencing.
And, have you progressed with it very far, or?
I'd say I'm probably better than when I started, which was 2 years ago, but I would still be pretty bad.
Well, that's, I don't know if like having the skill of stabbing people is really that good after all. So, you know, it's probably best for the best. It is time for us to head back into the game. And, Jim, it is over to you.
Thank you, Lori. Here's the team from Bishop Guertin High School. And after the first round, they have a lead over Merrimack High. But, you know, this is our bonus round. 10-point toss-up question followed by bonus questions to the team that gets the toss-up correctly. So good luck. Here we go. This is going to be a picture that you're going to look at, so take a look at it right here on this monitor. This French artist is best known for painting scenes of modern life, including this painting, a bar at the Folies Bergère. And the artist was Edouard Manet. In September 1975, this president faced two assassination attempts. Timothy or Bishop Guertin?
Gerald Ford.
Gerald Ford is correct for the 10 points. So let's go over to Guertin. Tim, you are the captain. You can talk to everybody up there, but I will take your answer as the team answer. You can choose from Dust Up, All Puffed Up, or Hey Jude. Dust Up, All Puffed Up, Hey Jude.
We'll take Hey Jude, please.
Let's go with Hey Jude. Identify the following Judes or Judases. English actor who played Watson in the 2009 movie
Jude
Sherlock
Law.
Holmes. Correct. Jude. Novel by Thomas Hardy.
Jude the Obscure.
Correct. English heavy metal band with two lead guitarists.
Judas Priest.
15 out of 15 on the bonus for Bishop Guertin. All right, for 10 points, there is paper and pencil in front of you. You might use it if you think you need it. We want you to find the product of 23 and 27. Simple as that. The product of 23 and 27. James of Merrimack.
611.
Bishop Guertin. It was Jeffrey.
711.
It was 621. When Rosa Parks refused to give up her seat on the bus, it was the first action in this protest campaign to end racial segregation on the public transit system of Montgomery, Alabama. Allison of Merrimack.
The bus boycott?
Montgomery bus boycott is correct for the 10 points. So let's go over to Merrimack. Allison, you are the team captain. You can talk to everybody, but I'll take your answer for the team. Let's choose a category from Dust Up, All Puffed Up, or Pen Name. Dust Up, All Puffed Up, or Pen Name?
Dust Up.
All right, let's go with the Dust Up. And again, Allison, you can talk to everybody, but I take your answer for the team for 5 points each. Second baseman for the Boston Red Sox.
Pass.
Dustin Pedroia. In the movie Tootsie, he played a character in drag.
Dustin Hoffman.
Correct. Former professional wrestler known as the American Dream. His name was Dusty Rhodes. We'll give you 5 out of the 15 and go with another 10-pointer. How many more edges than vertices does a triangular-based pyramid have? Timothy of Guertin.
1.
Merrimack. Maslin.
2.
Sure, why not? That's it for 10 points. Let's go back over to Merrimack. Allison, you can choose from All Puffed Up, Pen Name, or Seeing Red. All Puffed Up, Pen name or seeing red?
Seeing red, please.
Let's go with seeing red for 5 points apiece. Identify the following works of literature containing Identify the following works of literature that contain red or a shade of red. Novel about the Civil War by Stephen Crane.
Rivers of Blood.
Is The Red Badge of Courage. Novel featuring Arthur Dimmesdale and Hester Prynne.
Pass.
Is The Scarlet Letter. Novella by John Steinbeck about Jody Tiflin and his life on a ranch.
Red Letter Days.
It was The Red Pony. Tough category, but let's go. No, we won't. There's the sound. Ending the round, Bishop Guertin got that early lead in the first round, held on to it after round number two. But we come up next to our 62nd round, 110 points up for grabs for each team. Before we get there, though, here comes Lori once again, right now talking with the team from Merrimack High.
Thank you, Jim. We're talking to Allison right now. She is the captain of the team. Or, you know, as I refer to her, the queen. You are in the swim team. You're in the National Honor Society, improv acting. I mean, how did you... It's such a variety of interests.
Well, I think I have a broad range of things that I like doing, and I wanted to make sure I found time to do all of them. So I just devote a good amount of time and move on to a different thing, and it's fun.
I was saying to you earlier that I don't know how you guys find any time to sleep with all the activities that you do, as well as school.
Well, sleeping is an issue, but... I survive.
Okay, and when you get into college, there'll be more time to sleep, so that'll be good. James, now, tell us a little bit about you had this big trip that you took up to the Northern Tier.
Yes, about 4 years ago with my Boy Scout troop, I went up to Northern Tier in Minnesota. We went canoeing for 9 days straight up in the lakes between the U.S. and Canada. So it was nice, no cell phones, no internet, lots of stars, lots of mosquitoes, but... A lot of memories.
Probably not your favorite part of the trip, right?
No. About 8 o'clock every night, you'd have to get in your tent or face all the mosquitoes that would come out. But we were fine, and it was a great trip.
That sounds like it would be something that everybody should see at least once in their lifetime. Now, Maslin, you took the opposite track. You went down to D.C., to the big city, and you had a few adventures there.
Yeah. Last year, when I went with the robotics team, and... We went over, toured things, and had a robotics competition, and like saw the monuments and memorials and museums, and it was really nice. Had a good time.
And it's amazing to go see this stuff live in person when you've seen pictures of it, isn't it?
Uh-huh. Really is. Really liked the Museum of Technology.
Big surprise.
Yeah.
There's a big surprise, all right. And we also have Dan. Now, Dan... You are the most unusual one here today. Circus skills, how did you acquire them?
Well, in fifth grade, I decided that I liked the idea of unicycling, so I got a unicycle. And then in my sixth grade gym class, I learned how to spin plates and juggle.
Mm-hmm. And there are skills that you've continued to master, or?
Yeah, pretty much.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's and someday if we see you, like, I don't know, in the circus somewhere, how would we recognize you?
Probably be the one on a pogo stick. Yeah, that too.
Okay. Well, thanks so much. And Jim, we have to get back to you and find out who wins this game.
Okay, Lori, and there you see the team from Merrimack High School as we get ready for the third round. Our 62nd round, we'll be asking each team 10 questions in under a minute. If they get them all right, we'll give them 110 points because they'll get a bonus of 10. We'll give them 10 for every correct answer plus. The team trailing is Merrimack, so they will get to choose their category first. And Allison, you have your alternates up there to help out as well in this round. You can talk to them and decide on these categories. Monkey business, place names, ends in O. Monkey business, place names, ends in O.
The O one.
Ends in O. Okay, Allison, again, you can talk to everybody up there. You got the whole group with you. Identify the following words that end in O. Start the clock. Large Australian marsupial.
Kangaroo.
Correct. Bright pink bird with long legs.
Flamingo.
Correct. State where Pikes Peak is located.
Chicago. Ohio.
It is Colorado. Coriander is also known as this.
Oregano.
Cilantro. An electrically neutral element.
Pass.
Type of palm tree found on South Carolina's flag?
Palmetto.
Correct. Along with the id and the ego, it is the third part of Freud's model of the psyche.
Sagan. Super ego.
Correct. Term that taken from the Italian for outside dining?
Al fresco.
Correct. Cross between a cocker spaniel and a poodle?
Cockadoodle.
It's a cockapoo. Mm. Powerful wind that comes from the Sahara?
Pass.
It is the Sirocco. And I will turn over to the judges. And judges, they received 5 out of 10 on their 60-second round. So 50 points on the scoreboard for Merrimack. We go over now to Bishop Guertin High School. We'll offer them monkey business or place names.
We'll take place names, please.
Let's go with place names. And again, Timothy, you've got the whole team up there right now. You can talk to them, but I take your answers for the team. Identify the following individuals with names that are also cities. Start the clock. Socialite and heir to a hotel fortune.
Paris Hilton.
Correct. Author of Call of the Wild.
Jack London.
Correct. Author of Jane Eyre.
Jane Austen.
It is Charlotte Bronte. Singer known for her rendition of the song I Will Always Love You.
Whitney Houston.
Correct. He wrote the song White Christmas.
Irving Berlin.
Correct. Actor who has portrayed Steve Biko, Malcolm X, Reuben, and Hurricane
Denzel
Carter.
Denzel Washington.
Correct. This actor who got his big break in the film Stand By Me died when he was 23.
Pass.
She wrote Pride and Prejudice.
Jane Austen.
Correct. He was the 22nd and the 24th president of
Grover
the United
Cleveland.
States. Correct. He sang about a Rocky Mountain High and
John
country
Denver.
Roads. John Denver is right, judges. 8 out of 10 on their 60-second round. So 80 points onto the scoreboard for Bishop Guertin High School, and that'll bring us to the end of round number 3. Bishop Guertin got that lead early in the game, and they haven't eased up at all as we head into our 4th and final round. Good luck, teams. We have 10-point toss-ups the rest of the way. I just do remind you that if you buzz in, give a wrong answer, then we'll have 10 points deducted from your team's score. Here we go for 10 points. In 1897, this author sailed with his brother-in-law to join the Klondike Gold Rush. His time there most likely influenced some of his works, including Call of the Wild and White Fang, Timothy of Bishop Guertin.
Jack London.
Jack London is correct. Tom Edison's Shaggy Dog, a short story about how Thomas Edison discovers that dogs have superior intelligence, is one of the short stories found in this author's 1968 collection of short stories, Welcome to the Monkey House. The author was Kurt Vonnegut. This group met between 1545 and 1563. Dan of Merrimack.
The Illuminati.
I can repeat for Guertin. This group met between 1545 and 1563 as a counter-reformation move to examine doctrine and reform in the Catholic Church. It was the Council of Trent. All right, we have another video question for you. Let's take a look and a listen.
Hi, I'm Allie McNair. The first taxes for Social Security were collected in 1937. Name the president who signed the Social Security Act.
Timothy of Bishop Guertin.
FDR.
FDR, Franklin Roosevelt is correct. In 1903, using two of his inventions, he filmed and carried out the electrocution of Topsy the elephant, Dan of Merrimack.
Thomas Edison.
Thomas Edison is correct. Maurice Sendak included in his book, The Night Kitchen, an illustration of three bakers that resembled this partner of comedian Stan Laurel. Stan Laurel's old-time partner was Oliver Hardy. Iron Man creator Stan Lee has said that he based Tony Stark on this real-life inventor, playboy, billionaire, and eventual recluse. That was Howard Hughes. Got about a minute to go in our game. This theater was a key venue in the Harlem Renaissance and is famous for its amateur nights and helped launch the careers of Jimi Hendrix, James Brown, Stevie Wonder, and Mariah Carey. The name of the theater is the Apollo Theater. In 1914, in order to reduce attrition and maintain production levels, this auto company announced an 8-hour workday with a minimum wage of $5 a day. Dan of Merrimack?
Ford.
Ford is correct. The nuclear bomb dropped at Nagasaki, Japan, had a core made up of this transuranium element, Maslin of Merrimack?
Plutonium.
Plutonium is correct. This member of Monty Python was a writing partner of John Cleese and played King Arthur in the Holy Grail movie and Brian in The Life of Brian. His name, go ahead, David.
Graham Chapman.
Graham Chapman is right for another 10 points, just as the buzzer sounds, and that'll be Bishop Guertin with a good win tonight. Started early and kept right going, holding on to a 245-105 win over Merrimack High School this evening. So they move into the quarterfinals. Two new teams are going to be right here next week. Hope you will be too, because we're going to have another battle between two schools looking to advance in Granite State Challenge. They will be the Marauders of Hanover High School and the Astros of Pinkerton Academy. Thanks for being with us this week. See you next week. Good night, everybody.
Major funding for the production of Granite State Challenge has been provided by Unitil, Energy for Life, NEA New Hampshire, shaping the future one student at a time, with additional funding from Heinemann Publishing, D.F. Richard, Markham Image, Pax World Funds, and from viewers like you. Thank you.